What's up? This your number one boy girl Boots D, celebrity tarot card reader and psychic to the star. Look, bitch, I'm hungover as shit. And today, how we're gonna fix it is we're gonna motherfucking eat.
I go live on Instagram and Facebook,
and I read my own version of tarot.
So let me see what the hell is going on. Ooh. Yes, yes, all of this is good. You shooting shots and you making your dreams come true.
I am an experience, is what I am.
All right, so today we're eating from not the best choice of restaurant by popular gay man.
Oh, my Lord.
And it is McDonald's, okay? McDonald's has been my hangover cure since my college days. I used to throw parties every single weekend to pay for school. And afterwards, there was no restaurants open around except for Mickey D's. So I always make like a late night Mickey D's run before, I turned in for the night after I got out of the club. And I just grew to have this nostalgic relationship with McDonald's and their food. Now, you know, they say that they use slime in their products. They grind up the cow parts and make them into nuggets. But bitch, them nuggets was always hitting, if you ask me. The Big Mac, they saying it ain't as big as it was, and this new burger over here look like it got some type of bacon and some chili sauce on it. I don't know what McDonald's has going on, but what I do know is that I'm fucking hungry and I need to eat, especially after last night. So I'm gonna tell you guys what happened last night while I eat, and I hope you guys enjoy too. But before we do anything, there's one thing that we must do. Bow your heads. We gotta smoke.
I was gonna clean my room until I got high. I was gonna get up and find the broom, but then I got high. My room is still messed up, and I know why.
Why, man?
Yeah, cause I got high. Because I got high. Because I got high. La da 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 da. I was gonna go to class before I got high.
Come on, y'all. Check it out.
All right, now let us bless the food. God, I come to you with humbly as I know how, asking that whatever materials have been used in the preparation of this food are healthy and sanitized in your spirit. I pray that the slime that is created, used to make these chicken nuggets, goes down my digestive tract effortlessly. And I thank you for this meal. Amen. Ashe, whatever you say, it is okay. I'm hungry and I need to eat. So these are the chicken nuggets. As you can tell, Bloom, I don't really care or know what they are made out of, but we are going to consume them. And what we're going to use is the sweet and sour sauce. Now, I told that mug at the damn, when I ordered this, that I wanted all of the sauces. But they only gave me sweet and sour. So that's what we're going to work with today. All right. So sweet and sour sauce right here. We're going to dunk it. Blow, just like that. And we're going to put it in our mouth. Oh, my God. Oh, look how it's dripping. Last night. Oh, shit. So last night, the radio station sends me out there to grab a reading from Keke Palmer. And so basically, I get real cute. I have my legs out. I wear this negligee. The lace front wig was laid, so please don't judge it today because the humidity just made her inflate like a goddamn balloon. But I thought I was going to a gay club. No, sir. That was a hood black function I was at. So I get there. And they get VIP tickets to us. You know what I'm saying? I had the VIPs because of the radio station I work for, Power 98 in Charlotte. Now give me the tickets. I go in there, I storm the place. You know, me and my hairstylist, Renee. Y'all know Renee if y'all watch me on Facebook and Instagram. You know, she was right behind me. You know, she always had my back. And she was walking behind me or whatever. And all you see is they were parting like the goddamn Red Sea. They could not take. Them niggas could not breathe. it was almost like the coming of the apocalypse came up in that club. You know, girls started stop dancing, dudes started moving and jarring. There were a couple of comments that were being made to Renee. And they were like, we had to check to see if you was a real girl because you with her or whatever. And Renee was like, bitch, don't fucking try me. Like, Renee will turn up for her boots, honey. Very protective. Just like you guys are online with me. I'm going for the Big Mac right now. Okay. Ooh, my God. And I'm trying to be healthy. So I told him to put extra lettuce on there. That's why you hear that crunch. Look at that neck. It is so refreshing. And I'm drinking high C. But Renee had to get protective a couple of times. We did good with the interview though. Kiki Palmer is a sweet, sweet girl. And she's very humble and accepting of who I was too. And I really, really appreciated her for that. But yeah, girl, I thought the gay function was during the day and the nighttime. So basically Kiki was booked twice at the same place because they had two different events going on. And the radio station sent me to the nighttime event. Had I known I was stepping off into that environment, I mean, I would have dressed for the occasion, but bitch, I was damn near naked out there. Wearing my mom's old nightgown. But it was fabulous nonetheless. Y'all know that feeling like when you get nauseous because you're hungover, but the food is like nourishing you at the same time? That's kind of what I'm going through as of right now. And I'm real hot too, girl. I don't know what temperature it is where y'all live. Go ahead and down there and drop in the comments. How hot is it where you located? It is hot. Real hot. Anyway, so to get comfortable, you know, I buy a couple of bottles of Ciroc. Because I was like, okay, we're going to go up in here. If we got to be in this environment where everybody... And I wish I could paint the picture for you. Maybe I'll do it with the food. No, I'm not going to do it with the food because I don't want to mess up the display. The display. Anyway, but basically, like, people... we sat in the VIP and everybody just kind of moved back. Like, you could just tell they were uncomfortable. Straight dudes didn't know how to respond to me. Females were, I don't know what they was thinking, child. I couldn't get in their head. I think they were thinking I was fabulous. And some of them was probably trying to figure out why my lace front is laid better than theirs was. Excuse me. But it was just interesting. It's an interesting level of society or socialization or what's the word I'm looking for? Sociology. There we go. It's like, from a sociological perspective, it was just interesting to see the dynamic of people. And it would have been so cool to get that on camera. But I was just recording, you know, random stuff while I was there with Nay. You know, nothing too major. I had fun last night. But I got those bottles of Ciroc because I was like, okay, well, I need to take the edge off a little bit. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm in this new environment. I thought I was walking into something, ended up walking into something else. And so we buy out the bar. We're sharing shots at this point in time. Now, I always know when you give somebody something, they will respect you. So I just started buying shots for everybody. And by the end of the party, Kiki Palmer was on stage. And everybody's around me. And it's like we created this unity thing that worked all because of, you know, we had a common goal, which was Kiki. But their guard came down when they saw that, okay, he's turning up in his own way. He's buying us drinks, you know what I'm saying? He's buying out the bar, he's sharing it with the people. We can have some type of respect. And not to mention, Renee looked good as the fuck last night. So she was, people was trying to talk to her. But, you know, Renee is a faithful girl, which is appreciative, you know what I'm saying? But I was just looking, and again, I'm gay. So I don't really participate in, you know, heterosexual activity. And so I gotta scratch my itch out. This wig has put me through the storm. Anyway, so I've never really like watched guys hit on girls. I mean, you know the concept and stuff like that or whatever, but to see it actually in action, it was really interesting. It was. They would walk right up to her and be like, yo, what's up, mom? And I was like, niggas really do this shit? I guess the gay world is a different breed. And I guess the guys that I'm attracted to is different, too. Like, they would never just walk up to me and be like, hey, what's up, bruh? Like, I'm trying to get at that. You know, what's good? Like, let me take you home in that lace. And, you know, let me take your lace front wig off. Let me put your lace front wig back, bitch. You know what I'm saying? I don't never get approached like that. You know, I get approached with... You know. Ooh, shit. That high C hit on everything. Ooh, okay, let's try this new burger real quick. For some reason, I'm getting full. I know this is probably going to be a short fucking video because I'm full already. I'm not even really hungry. I didn't even smoke that much. Y'all know the first video, I was smoking like hell. I was high as a bitch. Right now, I just needed something to take the edge off from this hangover. I don't like that. Get rid of that new burger, bitch. Get rid of that new burger. That ain't right. That ain't right. No, sir. That ain't right. That's not right. That is not right, honey. I gotta chase that with some liquor, child. Dulce, whatever the hell they say. Okay, Dulce, I say, and what I say goes. It's the texture. I don't know if it's because the cheese was melty or what. I'm a texture type of girl, okay? Like, texture with the hair, texture with the food. It's got to be right. And that is not right. It doesn't make me not want any of this food. It makes me not want any of this food. Like, fuck all of this. McDonald's used to be the hangover cure, and now I need a cure for fucking McDonald's, okay? Fuck that bullshit. Now, their apple pies are still good, though, you know? Like, here's a little apple pie right here. Let's see what the hell is going on. Okay. Look, it don't even look like nothing in there. They must have changed the recipe. Okay. It's a no for me. Back in the day, okay, cool. Now, nah, hell nah, fuck that. Fuck this. Anyway, I love you guys very much. I don't want no more of this food. And I'll see y'all on next Sunday dinner when we're gonna eat something with some substance, put some meat on your bones. Cause this shit right here.
I go live on Instagram and Facebook,
and I read my own version of tarot.
So let me see what the hell is going on. Ooh. Yes, all of this is good. You shooting shots and you making your dreams come true.
I am an experience, is what I am.